Welcome back, everyone. This week on Newsmaker, we're talking EMS, Emergency Medical Services, and Katie Hill is our guest, an EMT, registered nurse, and head of EMS services for Iowa Health Des Moines. Katie, thanks for being here. Off camera, we were talking about, 12,000 EMT?
EMS. 12,000 EMS providers in the state of Iowa working.
So obviously there's a lot of activity going on in the community involving EMS. So it's got to be a great thing for a community to have this. What difference does it make in a community to have EMS services?
Well, not only to provide the emergency care, but there's also a tremendous amount of education and community support that goes on from the EMS providers within the community. You know, whether it's safety education or providing BLS education for the high school seniors,
BLS.
You know, before basic life support, so teaching them how to do CPR. Or use an automatic defibrillator that we see in so many of our public facilities. So they do a tremendous service just as far as educating the public.
Well, EMS personnel are involved in saving lives and making us feel comfortable in cases of emergency and stuff like that. But I know there is a risk involved in this profession as well, right?
There is. It's a high speed, high stress, and quite frequently, you know, high risk field, whether it's physical injuries to you as you're performing your job. The emotional stress of it is obviously something that we take very seriously. So we all know people who've been injured in the line of duty, and that's something that we try to obviously prevent through safety initiatives and education.
And is this part of what the Iowa Association or the Iowa EMS Association does?
It is. We try to take initiatives through either legislation or training or grants that will help to provide a unified voice to speak for safer practices, safer equipment, safer vehicles. You know, when you see lights and sirens behind you, what are the legislation initiatives that help everybody to remain safe in that, and you know, in that situation? So we work with the government and with agencies to kind of try and stabilize those unstable scenarios.
I know, and coming up, I know we have, is it EMS Week starting next weekend, is that right?
Yes, EMS Week is a national week that we honor all those who are emergency medical service providers, and this year it's May 15th through the 21st, so there's numerous activities and lots of fun things for us to do.
As you mentioned, how many thousands of them are there
yes.
out there? So, you know, if you know one, go ahead and, you know, say thanks for what you do.
That's right. Let them know you appreciate them.
And on the other side, I know you're having a special memorial service, too, because, as we mentioned, there are dangers involved in this profession.
There are. In 2007, the Iowa EMS Association went on a fundraising campaign to kind of establish a central location where we have an EMS memorial. And it's a sculpture. It's located in West Des Moines at their public safety station on Mill Civic Parkway. And it has the names engraved on one side of those who have perished in the line of duty providing emergency medical services. And then the other side has names of EMS providers who have contributed to the overall field of EMS throughout the state of Iowa. So it's a really nice way to honor those who have contributed.
Indeed it is. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much for being here. We are honored to have you here with us, Katie Hill, and we are honored to have you join us every week on Newsmaker. That's it for this week. Thanks for being here.